Good morning, all of you. I'm happy to meet you in this class of commercial communication. And we are going to discuss today a very important unit of our course, and that is letter writing. We know that business means two parties come into contact. You may call those parties a buyer and a seller, a manufacturer and a buyer, or a wholesaler and a manufacturer. Whatever you may name them, but they come into contact. They develop relationship. They try to sustain the relationship. And ultimately, they see to it that their relationship ends into a profitable relationship, meaning both the parties look for their own advantage. We know that it's very necessary to develop a good relationship. It is said that letter is a very, very important tool for communication. It helps in creating relationship, nurturing relationship, and sustaining the relationship. Today we are going to talk about three different types of letters: inquiry, quotation, and order letters. Now all these three letters, they form a basis, they form an initial part of the relationship between the two business parties. We know that before any buying and selling takes place, there is a long procedure, there is a long piece of communication that happens between the two parties, and that happens in the form of inquiry, quotation, and finally there is placing an order. Now let's imagine a situation. There is an individual who happens to come across an advertisement, and he gathers an idea. Why not sell the newly introduced watches? Let me collect details. And then the thoughts trigger in his mind, and he starts thinking about what must be the price range of the kind of watch that has been advertised. What is it made of? What must be the major shapes and sizes in which this kind of watch is available? What are the popular color combinations? Or he may also think about the special features of the watch that has been introduced in the market. He might think of whether these watches will be available in ready stock and on what terms and conditions the supplier or the manufacturer will be ready to provide the watches. These are some of the common questions that might come to his mind. Now, one of the alternatives that he might accept is immediately picking up a phone. We know that it's a very convenient mode of communication. So by chance, you know, he picks up a phone. There might be a dialogue between the individual and the person on the opposite side saying that, "Hello, good morning, sir. I'm very happy to come across your advertisement, and I would like to know more details about the watch that you have recently advertised." From the opposite end, there might be a response: "Good morning, sir. I welcome your inquiry, and may I know what are the details that you would like to know?" And there might be again questions from the inquirer, and he might say that, "Sir, I would like to know the shapes and size and the colors in which your watches are available, and what is the approximate price range, and are they available in ready stock?" And the one who receives the phone might respond by saying that, "Sir, it would be no doubt I am ready to respond to all your queries, but it would be more convenient if you send all your queries in writing." in this case, you know, the inquirer will have an alternative. These days we all go for the quicker means of communication. We go for emails, but emails are no doubt a good way of communicating, but electronic form has its own limitations. So even today, in the environment in which we are living, we still prefer writing letters, because the letters can be preserved, they can be referred back as and when necessary. And from the writer's part, there are distinct advantages. He can write all the details quite at length. So considering the advantages of letter writing, the prospective buyer who would like to either buy some goods or hire services may prefer to write a letter. Now let's see which way the letter he might shape his ideas. We all know that a business letter is almost in the style in which we talk to each other. Here is a sample letter, which is of course a very, very simple style of writing, which says, "Dear Sir, we shall appreciate further information about Cami watches that you have advertised in the Times of India of 28th September 2010. Further, it says, this is the second paragraph of the letter, "We are basically interested in designer watches in attractive shapes and colors, as they are in great demand these days." This is the third stage of the letter. "We would particularly like to know your terms and credit of and discount." And this is the concluding part. "We have been in the business for about 30 years and are likely to handle large orders. Please send us your latest catalog and price list. Yours faithfully." You can see that, you know, in this letter, if we go back to the beginning part, the letter opens by quoting the source of information. Now, the source of information is Times of India, the advertisement that appeared in a particular issue of Times of India. And in the second paragraph, the writer mentions about his own expectations, what kind of watches that he would like to buy, and what is his principal aim of writing this letter, that he clarifies in this part. In the third part, he of course mentions, "We would particularly like to know your terms and of credit and discount." And in the final part, he says, "We have been in the business for about 30 years. So he provides his own background. Now the thing is, you know, when such a this is one kind of inquiry made by a prospective buyer. This letter is written in response to an advertisement, so it is known as a solicited kind of inquiry. Now inquiry letters, they are written on different occasions. Say for example, sometimes the inquiries are sent on buyer's initiative, meaning of his own, the buyer decides that, "Let me inquire about a certain product available in the market." So without any special advertisement, he approaches the manufacturer or the wholesaler and puts forward his queries regarding the products and the services. The second possibility of sending an inquiry letter is on seller's initiative, as we saw in the previous example, that it is the manufacturer who invites, it is the wholesaler who invites the inquiry from the prospective buyers, and the buyers write in response to the advertisement that they have come across. So that becomes the second important event of writing an inquiry letter. The third type The third possibility is a routine inquiry by an old buyer. Let's imagine that a person regularly buys certain kind of watches from a certain company. So he would like to know whether there are any changes in the models or sizes, or if any terms and conditions have been changed. So in order to get information about these details, he might send an inquiry. And the fourth possibility is about inquiring for special terms and conditions. Now let's turn further and there is one more example which says that, "Dear sir, we are in the market for the sale of furniture since last 20 years. Here the writer begins straight away by providing self-introduction. Further, he elaborates his point by saying that we would like to know whether you manufacture steel cupboards measuring 60 by 30 by 20 inches. He mentions about the size. In the second part of his letter, he mentions, "We are particularly interested in cupboards and safes and olive green colors. Please also inform price range of various models. We would appreciate having the information within 15 days. As we see the beginning of the letter, we can see that this is an unsolicited kind of inquiry, meaning the buyer of its own. He approaches the seller and he tries to collect information about the kind of goods that he would like to buy from him. Now, we know that, you know, sometimes the writers, the business people, they invite, you know, quotations. Quotation, as we are aware, quotations follow the price range, the details about the price and all other things sent by the manufacturer. And as a result, when the inquirer sends the details about what kind of particular requirements does he have, then he sends a letter asking for quotation. Here there is a specimen of a letter written with a request for sending a quotation. You can see that the letter has a usual format. It starts with the heading and then there is an inside address and there is a subject also. And the letter says, "Dear sir, we would like to get further information about your new range of colorful plastic chairs advertised in the latest issue of the Sunday Observer, Mumbai." So once again, we see that this is a solicited kind of inquiry. "We are sure that a good market exists for the chairs, especially in the numerous offices in this area. We are in a position to place large orders with you at regular intervals. Therefore, we look forward to receiving a favorable quotation from you. We would appreciate full information on the following points." And then he enumerates the points that he would like to know from the recipient of this letter. The points are your lowest price for bulk orders, discount permissible, mode of payment, mode of delivery, sizes and colors available. "We would also like to know whether it will be possible for you to deliver the first order by October 20th, 2020, well before the Diwali festival celebrations. We look forward to placing large orders with you if your quotation is found satisfactory." And then below there is signature in the usual style. What is important about this letter is that the writer of this letter, he not only mentions the source, but he also informs about what kind of goods that he is particularly interested in, where he says that we are sure that a good market exists in this for the chairs, especially in the numerous offices in this area. So there is a good demand for chairs in this area. He emphasizes the need to respond to this inquiry by making this statement. We are in a position to place large orders with you at regular intervals. This is also an indirect incentive to the seller to respond to the letter immediately, because the statement shows that there is a possibility of having a good business. And the middle part, where the points have been numbered, they are of special importance in this letter. We can see that, you know, both the letters, both the samples that we have seen, they are written in the most simple and natural language, the way we generally talk to people on telephone, in the same tone, in the same language, easy and day-to-day language, the letters have been written. Now, any letter is basically meant for a response. If there is no response from the recipient, then there is a breakdown in communication. So we say that a letter should be written with you attitude. Now, in case of an inquiry letter, how can we have you attitude? Now, there are two points that are very prominent in this letter, which shows that this letter has been written from the reader's point of view. The first one is where the writer mentions that we are in a position to place large orders with you at regular intervals. This particular sentence, it initiates the reader to respond to the inquiry immediately, because any seller would be interested in making good profit. And if there are chances of getting regular orders, bulk orders, then naturally the seller would be interested in responding to the inquiry immediately. Same way, in the third stage, where the points of inquiry have been numbered, that is, you know, again it reflects that the writer is trying to help the reader to respond to the letter. The reader will come to know which are the points that the writer is interested in knowing from him. Now, when you list out